Dear students, now we come to the last lecture of this third unit, which is pertaining to central dogma and reverse central dogma. This is also a 7-mark question that could be commonly asked there in the semester examination. First, we will try to understand what is a central dogma. Look at the diagram there in the right hand side. The genetic information is flowing from DNA to RNA and from RNA to protein. So, it's an unidirectional flow of genetic information. This flow is referred as a central dogma. So, the central dogma was first proposed by Francis Crick in molecular biology, mainly to show the flow of genetic information from DNA to protein via an RNA molecule. Thus, it's a unidirectional way of genetic information flow. So, the central dogma leads to the expression of protein information that has been encoded there in the genome. Information present in the DNA molecule has been passed on to the protein. It does not come out. In other words, if you want to say, it's an unidirectional flow. That is from DNA to RNA and from RNA to protein. It won't flows back. So, the amino acid sequence that have been present in the polypeptide chain cannot able to influence the synthesis of a DNA or RNA or other polypeptide chain. So, this kind of a unidirectional flow of information was referred by Crick as central dogma in molecular biology. Thus, the information once got into the protein cannot able to flow back into the nucleic acid. That's it's a unidirectional flow of information. Next comes the reverse central dogma. In order to understand about the reverse central dogma, first we need to know the hypothesis stated by Barry Comner. He is a person who suggested the genetic information could be flowing in a circular manner. That is, DNA transcribes into RNA, RNA translate into protein. The proteins can influence the synthesis of an RNA and RNA can able to synthesize the DNA, or circular flow of the information. Another important discovery that shaped the reverse central dogma is by Baltimore, Mizizuma and Timmin. Is also referred as a Timmins hypothesis that involved the presence of enzyme reverse transcriptase. This reverse transcriptase enzyme is present commonly in certain oncogenic viruses such as Rouse sarcoma virus or the HIV viruses. They are all certain RNA containing viruses. Even the family retroviridae has gained a lot of importance there because of the presence of this enzyme. This enzyme is also referred as a RNA-directed or RNA-dependent DNA polymerase enzyme or reverse transcriptase enzyme. Identification of this enzyme gained a lot of importance there to study about the oncogenic viruses, for which identification of this enzyme has paved the way for studying about the oncogenic viruses. For this, Baltimore and Timmin has been awarded the Nobel Prize in Physiology and Medicine. Thus, the tumor viruses found to contain the reverse transcriptase by which an RNA-DNA hybrid molecule can be produced there in the cell. So, you look at the diagram there on the left-hand side. From the RNA, a DNA-RNA hybrid has been formed with the help of a RNA-dependent or RNA-directed DNA polymerase, which is also commonly referred as reverse transcriptase. So, this DNA-RNA hybrid can be easily incorporated there into the genome of the host cell. Such kind of a retroviral insertion there into the host genome is also one of the reason for the triggering of cancer, especially in the Rouse sarcoma virus. Say, this kind of a insertion can trigger the proto-oncogene, an integral gene related with the control of cell division into a oncogene. That is, a normal gene is converted into oncogene, and the agent that is responsible for transforming this healthy cell into a cancer cell is actually the retrovirus. When the DNA-RNA hybrid is got integrated there in the genome of the host cell, the virion also found to contain the DNA polymerase enzyme, which can replicate the double-stranded DNA that could be present there. So, this exciting finding in the molecular biology has given rise to the concept of the central dogma in a reverse manner. So, it can be simply defined as shown in the last line. Reverse central dogma refers to information flowing from RNA to DNA instead of unidirectional flow of information from DNA to RNA.